So Joseph Parker knocks out Shaundell Winters in the fifth round. This was Joseph Parker's first fight now since June of last year. So by his standards anyway, that's very inactive for him. You know, he's been quite active over the years, pretty much the years I've seen him fight. He's always got at least two fights in a year. So last year was a very inactive year. He didn't look rusty in this fight necessarily, but I don't know. He just seemed to be missing a step, I think. Like, in parts he looked good, but then in other parts he just looked a bit kind of, you know, I don't want to say sluggish, but in some ways he did. Because the first two rounds Parker came out, you know, asserted himself reasonably well. You know, he was boxing a bit, but he was letting the shots go, that has to be said, and he was catching Winters with some right hands now and again. Winters, for the most part, for the first two rounds, didn't seem bothered, and actually came and landed a few good body shots at the end of the second round. Now, don't get me wrong, the first two rounds were Joseph Parker. The third round came along, and again, we see Parker kind of trying to box, not really using his, you know, speed, explosiveness. Whenever they get in close, I mean, Parker was doing what he needed to do. He would, you know, hold on to Winters. He wasn't leaning on him or anything like that I could see anyway. But he was definitely using the extra weight. I think he had something like, I think he had damn near 30 pounds extra weight on him. I think Parker was 245. I think Winters was only like 208. You know, really a cruiserweight. So Parker was doing that. He landed a good right hand at the back end of the third round. Now, he landed some right hands earlier on in that round, and Winters seemed to take them pretty well, actually, it has to be said. And Parker seemed to load up on those right hands. Winters took them well, but he landed a right hand at the end of the third. Winters went down, and he didn't look that badly hurt, it has to be said. Now, obviously, he was hurt when the right hand went in, and he went down, but he didn't look, you know, massively out of it or anything like that. And actually, to be fair, in the fourth round, actually, it was, he came back, and he actually, for my money, I think he actually took that round. I think he nicked it. Parker actually ended up getting a cut. I believe it was over his left eye, I think it was. And the commentary team, because I watched this on the Zone feed, the commentary team did even mention that they thought Parker maybe did look a bit sluggish, that he didn't look exactly, you know, all there. And they actually made reference to a spider bite that happened to Parker in the camp for the Chisora fight. And they said, look, has he fully recovered from that? And they were taking, they kind of giggled a bit, but they said, look, all joking aside, he couldn't train with that. And, you know, that has to be said, you know, has he recovered from that spider bite? I found it very funny. I think Joseph Parker released a picture, I think it was on his Instagram page there a couple of days ago. And I found it kind of funny that no one commented, no one noticed that he had a Spider-Man t-shirt on. You know, the Peter Parker t-shirt he had on. No one commented on that, but he had that. So, you know, he was making references to the spider bite all week. But, you know, he did look a little bit sluggish, but at the end of the day, it has to be said, he wasn't in there with much against this Winters guy. Winters, I think, was in his late 30s. He's lost a couple of times, really cruiserweight. So, could you blame Parker for not really getting up and, you know, looking his best in this fight? It's the same when he fought Leopold last year. You know, he fought an absolute no-hoper. Leopold was never that good anyway. And, you know, that was, what, 5-6 years ago. So, the last two guys Parker's fought, they've been less than stellar. And he's got the job done, it has to be said. So into the fifth round we went, and Parker, again, he landed some right hands at the early part of that round. Didn't appear to do anything to Winters, but then he landed another right hand, which did buzz him, landed a combination, and knocked Winters damn near out of the ring. Knocked him damn near out of the ring. Winters got back to his feet. He beat the count, but he was all kinds of fucked up. So referee was never going to let that fight go on. Stop the fight then and there, and correct decision, has to be said. Parker moves on, he gets the nice stoppage, gets the win. You know, my assessment of his performance was, yes, I think I know Parker can look better. I've seen him look better. Do I think he was a bit sluggish? Yes. Do I think the ring rust had something to do with it? Yes, because you talk about a guy who's been very active over the last few years. Even his last fight, he was only out of the ring for, what, 6 months? Going into from his last fight to the fight before. So, bit of inactivity for Parker, looking a bit sluggish. Obviously, still recovering from the spider bite, it has to be said. You know, I'm sure that whatever happened, you know, maybe he wasn't feeling the best. He probably hasn't been able to train as hard as he wanted to. So, all them things taken into consideration. The weight as well for Parker. Whenever I see Parker come in the mid-240s, he always looks a bit ploddish, a bit sluggish. I think Parker, when he's in the 230s, he looks a lot better. He's faster, he's more explosive. I think he's just an all-around better fighter when he's in the 230s. When he's in the mid-240s, that's when you start to see a slower Parker. He plods a bit more. and I just don't think it's a good way for him. So that was my thoughts on this. Let me know your thoughts down below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like, subscribe, of course, if you are new. And as always, I will talk to you after.